Hey everyone, thanks again for tuning in to Boating with Lucas. My name is Lucas, and today I will be taking you through one of my personal favorites, the 795 Game King from Extreme Boats. That's 26 feet overall, 8.2 beam. She is a solid aluminum vessel, 8 millimeters thick at the bottom and the hull sides. All welded construction, no foam, no rivets, beautifully finished in the gel coat like paint that they provide at the factory. This particular model sitting on a custom tandem axle Trailmaster trailer with custom aluminum alloy two-tone rims. Coming down the side of the boat, we do have the optional guard at the transom here, so when you're pulling out of the dock, you have this nice piece of starboard protecting your transom and the side of your hull from any dock scuffs. Coming to the back, this particular model is powered by a Mercury 350 Verado in a Mercury 99 EFI Pro Kicker for trolling. We also have electro-tab trim tabs, 3-in-1 transducer for all our Lowrance units inside, and I'll get to that in a minute. All of these Extreme boats out of New Zealand come with a flooding keel. So I don't know if you can see here, but there is a two open triangle holes at the peak of the dead rise. So when the boat comes off of plane and to rest, the water is going to flood the keel, giving the boat more displacement in the water, thus making it way more stable than your average aluminum or fiberglass boat. All right, guys, we're in the cockpit of our Extreme boat 795 Game King. Again, that's 26 feet overall. First thing I'm going to point out is the gray over black SeaDek throughout the swim platform, cockpit, and cabin. Super easy to clean, great stuff. It also serves as kind of an anti-fatigue mat if you're out fishing all day. Something cushy to stand on. It's easier on your back and your knees after a long day of fishing. Coming to the back of the boat here, we do have our optional bait prep station, the two lockable drawers that are carpet lined, a starboard bait cutting area with a drain, so you can drain everything through there and then drain out the back of the boat. You also have utensil holders for pliers, screwdrivers, whatever you keep with you when you're fishing, as well as built-in rod holders. So this station right here is one of my favorite upgrades with the Extreme boats. They're very versatile. It gives you a lot more usable space. This model has Cisco fishing rails for slide-in rod trees. Another really great feature I like to point out on these Extremes is the unique knee hand washing system. So done cutting your bait, done throwing your fish in the bait well, you can actually come aboard here, tap your knee with this knob. Water's actually gonna pull up from the lake or ocean, whatever body of water you're on. And you can wash your hands right out this through hull fitting. So there's no more reaching over the side of the boat to get some water to get your hands clean. That's all taken care of right here by our knee hand washing, and we have an adjoining one on this side. Also run off that same pump is your regular washdown system, which is raw water. As I mentioned a few seconds ago, extremely large live well, aerated, and it's nice that it's clear see-through as well. That's actual glass in there. Here you're gonna find all your rigging and your battery compartments, as well as the bilge space and bilge pump is behind that panel down below. Real quick, I want to mention this third Lowrance unit that does tie into all the other units that are in the cabin. This will have your GPS, engine instruments, and 3-in-1 fish finder. Underneath these seats, you will find storage, all carpet lined, very high quality upholstery, I might add as well. Great stuff. One thing I really like about these boats as well is I'm a taller guy. I'm 6'1", 6'2". The gunnels are very high. You feel very safe in a rough day. You don't feel like you're gonna fall in. It's a very stable boat, very high-sided boat. Taking a walk up onto the bow, you'll notice we carried the SeaDek theme up on the gunnels and up on the bow instead of the gray. We went with a matte black finish. Looks really sleek. It's great for anti-slip and safety. Because if this wasn't here, this would all be smooth paint. Great for looks. For functionality though, this is a way better option. You have traction everywhere you go. If you need to run up here and grab a dock line, or if you just want to come up here at any given time, if you're washing the boat, it's a great added safety feature. We do have a hatch that goes down for ventilation and light that goes down into the V berth down below. Coming up here, this is our windlass anchor system. We do something a little unique versus the traditional windlass. We do what's called a sav winch, which is a drum style winch, which is way stronger and way more effective than your traditional windlass that sometimes gets jammed or stuck. Delta plow anchor. We do have the split bow rail option for our optional Minn Kota trolling motor. We have the plate here ready for it. If people haven't used them for the actual trolling motor, we have used them for a step. So we'll just have a piece of SeaDek made, and then it can be made a step from the dock onto the boat. All right, everybody, just want to point out some features here on the hardtop of our Extreme Boat 795 Game King. We have an integrated solar panel for the electrical system, so when the motor is not running and your shore power is not plugged in, the batteries will constantly have a charge going to them via solar power. I'm going to point out all the LED lights on the boat. We do have two black oak spotlights on either side of the boat, great for the night bite, as they say. Also, we have Cisco downriggers too on both sides, great system. LED anchor light, twin dual roof hatches, great for ventilation on a warm day. Coming into the very spacious cabin of our 795 Game King, you'll find plenty of seating. Again, SeaDek throughout, great quality upholstery. Over to my left here, you will see, as I mentioned earlier up on the hardtop, the solar panel monitoring station. That will show you what charge the solar panels are giving your batteries, as well as some additional rocker switches here for some accessories such as the bait tank and lighting. Here you'll have a little space for, you know, if you want to have some sandwiches or some snacks out while you're fishing. As Rob comes into the boat here, you'll find the isotherm refrigerator freezer underneath the counter space with a little freezer compartment in there. Coming up to the helm, great visibility throughout. Opening vent windows on either side, starboard and port. We have our Lowrance HDS 16 display, so that's going to do everything that the one facing aft can do, such as engine instruments, navigation, your 3-in-1 transducer, your side scan, all that's going to be there, as well as here as well on the two Elite 7 units. Here's the switch for our sav winch, like I mentioned earlier, our drum style winch, very unique to us and our boats. Not too many others do that here. Again, controls and switches for all of our lighting and refrigerators, trim tabs. Coming up here, you'll see our Fusion Bluetooth sound system. Great unit, very user-friendly, pairs nice with all sorts of smart devices. You'll also see our GCOM ship-to-shore radio, which you will receive and, excuse me, you will transmit from here, and you can pick your station from here. You can also select it from here as well. Very spacious V-berth, sleeps too comfortably with equipped storage or optional porta potty, which can be done right here on that bracket. Coming to the port side of the cabin here, we have a very spacious dinette, room for two, with plenty of room for snacks and drinks on the table. And when the table is not in use, you can also use it as a secondary space for sleeping. You do need to lock it though. It can be taken out like that. And if you want to use this as a companion seat, a forward-facing companion seat next to your captain's chair, you can also flip this backrest around. Coming over here to our shore power panel, you'll see, you know, the volts you have coming into the boat, as well as your battery charger and your outlet. There is an AC 110 outlet in here in the V-berth. Charge your phone and any other thing you might want to plug in. So guys, I really appreciate you taking the time to watch this video. Again, this is our 795 Game King by Extreme Boats. If you guys would like any more information about it or your personal test ride, you can contact me anytime at 440-915-8995. Always ask for Lucas. And if there's any questions I can help answer for you at any time, my phone is always on.